this point of time, let's head straight to the Paryatan Parv, where the Union Finance Minister Arun Jaitley is speaking.
The minister rightly mentioned that world over, tourism has become one of the most powerful economic resources. As the world has got increasingly integrated, and as economic prosperity increases by the day, the desire to travel and see other parts of the world always increases. And it's quite obvious that India as a large nation is a part of that exercise. Geographically, we have the size and we have both the explored and the unexplored areas of tourism. It's no rocket science. It's well known that what are the areas which actually attract tourism? Religion and culture attract tourism, history attracts tourism, nature attracts tourism, great economic activity attracts tourism, cosmopolitan towns attract tourism, and India doesn't appear to be lacking in any one of those areas. We have places of worship of multiple religions located in India, shrines which are globally regarded, which were built during the historical periods, which retain their elegance and everlasting memory, and where people are willing to come and spend their time in those cities and locations where those shrines are. You have one of the largest sea coasts in the world. There are some beautiful beaches comparable to any part of the world. You have mountain resorts, you have forests, you have wildlife, you have cities which have moved up in the global ranking. And one of the emphasis areas, you have historical monuments. We've seen countries with one or two historical monuments. The manner in which they are able to market those monuments globally. Istanbul is an example. Cambodia is an example. Those historical monuments itself have a capacity to attract millions every year. And the minister rightly mentioned that tourism as a resource where those who can spend and provide employment to those who need the jobs. Now, historically, despite having these resources, there were many areas we lacked in. We lacked in connectivity. We lacked in large size airports. We lacked in domestic infrastructure. And I think this is one area in the last few years where India is making substantial advances and headways. Many of our major airports in the country are today comparable to the best in the world. We can now see the potential of airline travel not only in world quality airports in major towns, but even regional towns being connected. And I think with the emphasis on regional connectivity, there will hardly be an area in the country which is not well connected. We still need to do a lot of homework on improving the quality of rail travel in our stations, and that's why the government has undertaken this program of getting the private sector in order to improve the quality of air stations itself. And today about 400 stations are on the anvil, some contracts have already been awarded, so that there is a rebuilding like of the airports in the case of railway stations itself. You need hotels of all kinds. And of course, it was rightly mentioned that you need hotels at the lower tariff ends, where people who want to pay competitive fares also pay those competitive fares. And then, of course, you need historical monuments to be maintained. You need the ability to reach those monuments to be easy. And I'm glad that you've taken this initiative of inducting private citizen groups, corporates and otherwise, to aid and assist in the maintenance of monuments itself. Some of these monuments which have been handed over for maintenance to the corporate sector are world-class monuments. Each one of them has a capacity to really attract a large number of tourists itself. And I think most important, while we are in the process of improving our infrastructure, we need an environment of hospitality and warmth in the country to be created. We always believe that we are a hospitable nation, but our citizen attitude, the attitude of various trades in response to tourists, must also be extremely hospitable. And I'm quite sure that so far we've been inching ahead in the number of tourists. Compared to smaller destinations in the world, we still have been able to explore only a minuscule capacity of our tourists. And I'm sure if the initiatives that you are taking are fully utilized, we'll be able to carry this campaign a lot further and make some giant leaps. I once again compliment the department, and I'm sure in the years to come it will bring high-level dividends to the country itself. Thank you.
Thank you very much indeed. And ladies and gentlemen, may I now invite Joint Secretary Tourism, Mr. Suman Billa, to kindly propose the vote of thanks.
Honorable Union Finance Minister, Sri Arun Jaitley, Honorable Minister for Tourism, Sri K.J. Alphonse, Secretary of Tourism, Mrs. Rashmi Verma, distinguished